Live. Should be. This page. What's that? It's notifications. Some spam. Get rid of that. This one's not connected to the internet. Right. Here we are. Up and running. Well, in theory. Oh. I'm back. I forgot the USB stick, which has got the images and things that we're going to be playing with. I really wish the thumb drives, they would just right on the top of them. Which side's the top? So hello to those that are watching. Who have we got? I see Brad's there. I see some other familiar names. Right, so we have not touched this machine before. All I've done is I've managed to work out how to worked out how to connect the laser to the computer. I've managed to work out how to connect the laser doohickey to the computer. And I inscribed hello on a piece of cardboard, and that's all I've done. This is an X-Tool F1, which is got a blue laser and an infrared laser. And this is our first sort of play around with it. And I figured, well, why not? It just beeped at me. No idea why it beeped at me, but it beeped at me. We've got the rotary thing here as well. It's diode. So it's relatively low power. I think it's 10 watt. But I know it's good enough to mark nibs. And there's some other bits and pieces that I want to do with it, which we should be able to figure out whether we can do that or not. I've got an offcut of diamond cast that I'm going to try and put something on. I've also got an offcut of ebonite that I'm going to put something on. I've got an old Beaufort box, which is stainless steel, so we can mark that. I've got a bit of, I've got my my file scraper. It's got a wooden handle, so we can mark that. I've got my silicon resin mixer, so we can mark that. I have a leather pen pouch. I've got a business card. I've got a couple of discs of different materials that I use to make pens, so acrylic, alumilite, epoxy, and alumilite polyurethane. I've got one of my postage boxes. I've got three discs of metal. So I've got copper, brass, and silver nickel. I've got some notebooks. Got one with a card cover, one with a sort of leatherette cover, and one with a plasticky cover. And I've got a business card, which has got a spare bit of space that I can put a mark on to see whether that works. So I've got all sorts of bits and pieces that I'm going to try. I've also got a cup of coffee. But what we're going to try and do is figure out what the fuck we're doing. So I've got the software in front of me. I've just got laser flat, laser cylindrical, open plane, or laser extension. And I've got a USB thing that keeps popping up. So I might just eject that and get rid of it. Eject. Been ejected, we can now get rid of that and put it aside. Potentially mark a top on that with metal. Right. Use all for this to we've got different materials. All sorts of different materials. But I think the first thing is going to be working out how big our things are going to be. So this should be interesting. So what should we start with? We should start with image. Let's use an image. Okay. And I've done those images that I was going to use on the desktop. Props nib logo. There we go. There it is. The image is too large to be displayed upon cameras. Do I want to scale it? Yes. Okay, so we should just be able to keep the scale. All right, that's somewhere in the middle. There. framing to outline. All sorts of laser settings, so dot duration, power range, DPI, how many passes I'm going to do, bitmap mode, grayscale, it's like black and white really, black and white, there we go. Hello. How do I get it? That's this button here. Process. What do I How do I tell it to outline that? Ah, that's how you do it. Right. If I press framing, it does a preview of the image that I'm going to be doing on the workpiece. So that tells me that that is a bit too big. So I click framing again. Right, we're getting somewhere. So now if I hit process, that will then engrave that on there. In theory. Bear with me, this is work. Not sure you wanted to hear me speak about work. Right, what was I doing? Right, framing. So if I hit the framing button, which is this one just down here, that will then do an outline. You might be able to, I don't know if you can see the little... That then tells the laser to do an outline of what I'm trying to engrave on the material. So we've got that now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit process and see what happens. I've set it as square stainless steel sheet as the material. So we'll have a go. I'm expecting this to go wrong. Just in case. It does have a thing to, it's got a vent at the back. You know, the device or anything, but press the button on the device to start processing. Okay? Right, okay, that did subtle. Something's gone wrong. Try again. Let's make sure we're in the right place still so I move the thing. Yeah, fine. Process. Okay, why isn't this working? Again. So I've auto-focused it now, so let's see.
10. It's kind of pointless on this thing,
he's not fucking doing anything. Why isn't it doing anything? I'll find a better match for the material. There's one which was just used to find, didn't there? I'll just keep it on users, find material thickness. About half a mil. Okay. Try again. Will it do something this time?
It's doing something. Okay, so it's done something. How do I change the properties of the laser? Where was the thing which allowed us to change the stuff about the thing?
So it's not made a mark. Right, okay, so we've got a power range of 30. Let's see what happens now. Again, this could go wrong.
I've just increased the strength of the laser by 30%. So that wasn't marking it still. So I used the infrared laser. Keep it at those settings. Doesn't seem to be doing anything.
Maybe I should have started with something other than metal.
Okay, so that's done fuck all. Okay. Let's go back to blue light. Right, that's 500. Going to aim for 50%, we've got 49. Let's see. So the dot duration is how long it spends on each bit as it goes along. So in theory, if I'm upping that and I'm upping the power of the laser, it's more power on each individual bit as it moves along. It should leave a mark. I'm not expecting this to do anything.
Oh.
It's doing something. You can see those little flashes of light are doing something. Just for
no, it shouldn't. So we had a dot duration 500 and a power of 50. So that marks the stellar scale of 10. Okay. I'm trying to avoid looking at the directly at the flashy thing. So I'm going to stare into that camera there, which is not that camera there. I think it's done something this time.
Moved it. So we have a bit of a mark. point there. So if I go back, let's get the framing thing on again.
Line it up with the framing.
Stop framing. So that should be in exactly the same place as it was last time. So I'm going to up the power another 10%. I'm going to run it for another run. Or do I just, if I keep the power the same but increase the time that it's on each dot? Yeah, so I keep the power the same. I'll increase the dot by another 100. Can I just? So,
if it's set right, we should just get a better image. Yeah, I'm all right. Enjoy your meeting. Fair enough. Good luck.
Right, so we have gone from knowing nothing about lasers. To marking on stainless steel my logo, and it's come out pretty well. The darker bits, I think, are just I'm not sure why there's a why the lines aren't straight on the straight bits. I'm guessing something to do with the pixelation. Let's see. Alright, so that is how you will focus it. I know that. Okay, right, so let's see if we can take this image, spin it. Be able to flip it 90 degrees. Sharpness. There we go, it's off the flipping thing, isn't it? That's what I wanted. Right, so I don't want it to snap. Stop snapping. Framing. Framing. Is it 3.5mm corrugated? Grave. The DPI at 500. This is where it could all go from. Because this is a flammable material.
sets anything that laser, nothing's happening. Does it?
The infrared laser doesn't seem to want to work, which is the more powerful of the two lasers. Now, why is that? Is there a way that I can troubleshoot the lasers? Can I connect to the internet via this? Mobile hotspot on. That's the one. Right, so let's first of all
latest version. Okay. So how do I check?
Work again, bear with. Sorry about that. Right, so we've managed to mark some things on the using the blue laser, but we have not yet been able to figure out how to use the infrared laser. So we've managed to make that, and likewise in there you'll see a mark of the same image. And I'm just trying to figure out how to troubleshoot the lasers when I got a notification that someone's trying to get hold of me from work, which is handy. Just what I need on a Friday afternoon when I'm not working. How to check IR laser is working. Next tool. What? Let's have a look. Okay, so apparently the IR laser is used for metal surfaces. So whereas we used the blue laser on this, we should have been using the IR laser. So what we're going to do is set that next to it. Flip this back to rotate 180. No, 270. There we go. Resize it so it's a bit smaller. Use the framing to make sure we're in the right. There we go. Stop framing. We are going to use the fine material. We'll just stainless steel sheet. I think there's 0.5. And then we're going to go onto here. Engrave. I'm going to try and scroll down using the dot duration. Now this is what we want to go up. So we're going to have that on about 680. I'm going to put the power to 70%. And I'm going to give that a go and see whether that kicks in the infrared laser. Oh shit, didn't mean to do that. I'm not expecting this to work.
But just in case. It worked. Right. So that didn't really mark much of it. So if we put the duration dot duration up to 1,010, and we'll process that. We'll see what happens then. You can't really see what's going on, but yeah, see if I move the camera. Put up these the right thing.
I reckon if we do another pass at that, that'll be done. So, if we move this back down. I'm going to put the mask back on.
What I might do is just change the camera set for a bit. So that I am sitting... this side and the camera There we go. That's better. Right, so process again. Start. Press the button. Yeah, you can see the laser moving back and forth now. Mostly picky, pew-pew noises. Disappointing so far. Disappointed with the lack of sound effects.
So that's two passes of that infrared laser. I can definitely feel it. There's definitely a mark there. Crap. So, there we go. And this is what we did with the blue laser before on the cardboard. Obviously, the logo's upside down. It should be that way around. So, the one on the left was... This one here was blue laser. That one was infrared. This one was blue laser. So, there is some... marking on there, which I'm not sure what it is. It looks like bubbles, but right, so that's stainless steel covered off. So let's try the others. So I've got brass, copper, silver, nickel, and some offcuts that I've, well, I say offcuts, they're bits that I made yesterday. So we'll make this one so it sits smooth. Oh, this is the thing about trying to file coin-shaped objects. It's a real pain in the backside. Right, let's try copper first. I have to resize the image. So what we want to do... that nice and centralized. That'll do. That'll fit nicely. So you can see, you can't really see the blue on the, hang on, if I put that down, will you be able to see it? No. I'm going to also turn that so that you can see it better like that. Oh, you can almost see, oh no. Right, stop framing. Right, so copper. Not a copper on here. Got brass. Like aluminium. Official leather. Scratch paper, basswood. Brass again, aluminium, acrylic. rock.
Oh,
I could put a logo on my photo rock. Different metal. Right, so use defined material. Thickness, 2 mil. Yeah, 1.5. I reckon. That's 1.7. Fucking typical. Why did that go to 2? It was 1.7. That's not 2. Right, okay. Go back to here. Select the image. So, to set, from what I can figure out, to set the laser strength and everything, you need to select the image. So, I've selected the image. We are going to go infrared laser. And they go 1,250, and we're going to get 75%, or 75%. I'm going to wipe the DPI up a bit to 600. I don't know what Jarvis means. This is bitmap mode. And we're going to go for 2 passes. Process. I'm going to go get my mask on because
fuck knows what this is going to do. Definitely getting a mark.
Look, this is probably going to be quite hot. That's kind of cool. I like that. So that's the copper. Measure it first, don't I? And we're going to go that side rather than that side because that sounds like those marks on it. Right, this is 2-0. So, okay. So this is brass. So this does have a setting for brass. And it is 2 millimeters thick. Framing. So that's too big. So stop framing. Still too big. So we're going to whack it there. Now we have got this little bit of roughness on the end there, but I'm not worried about that for now. This is only playing around. We're going to do 3 passes on this one. We're going to go boop. Oh, actually doing something straight away there. I think 3 passes is a good one for this one. I wonder what happened. I upped the duration of that to about 800. Do another 3 passes on it with more time on each dot. You can still see the D and the P
on the tines. Right. Silver nickel next. So this is 3 mil. So this is going to be a very small one. So framing. I reckon we'll be able to get one in there. Because you don't have to worry about that top corner. So if we frame the actual picture, we can put it in an area where we know we're going to hit a nice spot. So there. So this is going to be used to find its material thickness is 3 millimeters. Cover down. Click on the image to set things. Manual setting. Infrared. So we want dot duration. We're going to wax that up to about 1, 2. That'll do. Power 80. DPI about 680. And we're going to have 6 passes because I want this to go quite deep. So I'm going to process that. I'm going to start. We'll see what happens. It's definitely marking it. I've lost count of how many passes this is.
Yeah.
Guessing that was 6.
So there we go. You can just about see the DP on the tines there. So we have success for stainless steel, silver nickel, brass, copper, cardboard. What should we do next? Hang on, where's my discs? So we've got acrylic. So two types of acrylic here. What's that? That is... two types of acrylic. We have epoxy, we have alumilite. So let's start with acrylic.
How thick is this acrylic?
Sorry, 2.1. So, let's go on to here, find acrylic. This is black acrylic, it's not black acrylic, it's steel.
I've been trying to I've got loads of different bits and pieces that I've gathered. a ham sandwich I might try, actually. That'd be quite with a little toasted patch with my logo on. Right, so this is 2 thickness. So this is going to be using the blue laser. And we're going to set dot duration about 500. Power, I'm going to whack it back down to 50. We're going to see what happens there. We're not going to do 6 passes, we're going to go 2. Because I've got a feeling with the plastics, these may melt. Framing, so framing process. This is where it could all go to. So, that's my phone, particularly when I have burning plastic fumes in my face.
And no, actually, I have actually put these materials aside. Okay, so that's... so you're going to have to up... I reckon we need to up the marking, up the power on this one. Okay. So, that's the power up to about 70%. Dot duration 660. I'll do three passes. See if that does any better.
So, because I had it on mute because of the phone call, it scorched it this side. As you can see, the material scorched that side. So, we're going to use the infrared laser on the other side and just get a comparative mark. Because this is all about, I'm not fussed if these little bits just go wrong. That's what they're there for. What I'm going to do, out there, and then we're just going to switch over to the infrared, and we're going to keep the same settings. And I'm expecting this to almost burst into flames.
Something's definitely happening. Right, so actually, the infrared lasers come out a hell of a lot better than the blue laser on the acrylic. So let's mark that down. So we want, what is it, brass? Brass. Silver, nickel, stainless steel, and copper. I'll add acrylic to that list. What we'll do is we'll whack this other colour. We'll give it a couple of goes with the. We'll give it a go on this side with the blue laser to see whether the blue colour of the material had an effect or not. That side, stop the framing, click on the image. So we're going to go blue light. Keep the same settings as before, so 660 on the duration, 71%, 680 dpi. And we're going to have three passes. I'm going to stop it there. I'll let that run for a sec.
As I could see something happening there, which I didn't particularly want to happen. So. It does mark it. Marks it pretty well. It cuts through it. So to use the blue laser, we need to down the power of the laser by a lot. But otherwise, that was pretty good. So I'm going to go back, get the framing right on this side. Yep. Stop framing. I'm going to go onto there and I'm going to down the power of the laser to about 30. No, that was 70. So I'm going to go 20. 19, that'll do. Fuck it. I'm going to see what happens then.
do fuck all.
Right, okay. So, let's up the power of the laser. So, we'll put it up 820 on the duration, and we'll put it up to 30%. I'll process it there. So, there's a little bit more power, a little bit more longer duration on each point. There we go. Hello, Mr. Hines.
Hello, Mr. Hines.
How are you?
See what that's done. It's definitely done a mark. Okay, so that gives us a indication of what those different powers of laser do. So if we use the other side to do the laser time, pew pew. So far, done that. I've done that. I think the one on the right is using the blue laser, the one on the left is using the infrared. These are all using the infrared, so we've got brass. Nickel, silver, nickel, whatever you want to call it. Maybe you see the does actually have the DP mark on the tines. Copper. And we got a bit of teal acrylic. We've marked it using the blue laser on the left and the infrared laser on the right. So I wax up the power, and we got the one on the left, which almost went through the entire thing, and then on the right, we put the power down again, still causing quite a lot of cutting action there. But now I'm going to try the infrared laser on the back page, on the back side, and I'm going to see what happens. So I have not used, just so that you're aware, this is my first time using the laser. I've not touched this software since I got it. I've not touched the laser since I got it. All I've done is installed the drivers, installed the the software itself, got an image I wanted to use. That's it. I've not played around with it. I've not looked at it. I've not looked at how-to videos. I've jumping in blind and just playing and seeing what happens. Because I learn by making mistakes. If I make lots of mistakes, then I learn lots. If I jump in blind, I'm going to make lots of mistakes. So I'm going to up the power to about 40. That'll do. Three passes, see what happens. Okay. It has got a fan at the back, but I'm making a habit of wearing the face mask.
So that started to do something, but then failed. So let's process that again, see what happens. Definitely doing something. But I didn't see the little. I'm just about to see it. Nothing you can see. So let's go back to here. Put up 50% power and duration up to there. We process it with that, see what happens. It's doing something. Very faint, just about to see it. Let's try. Different area of the coin, as it were. We're going to using that infrared laser. So 75% power. Do the three passes still. And process it there. Yeah, I've got some very faint markings and lots of bubbling. Okay. I suppose if I wanted to get the effects that I'm after, I could use the blue laser to create an indent and then backfill it. So let's try the one that's going to melt. We know this is going to melt, but it'll be fun to find out. do it that way. We've got a nice bit of I'm just going to keep the same settings. I'm going to try it straight away because I know that this one's going to go wrong. That better than I was expecting. Mask sat in my nose. Right, so we'll do these passes on this one. Have a look to see what the mark is, and then we'll try and mark the blue laser on the other side. The blue laser, I'll tell you now, will melt this material. But it'll be interesting to see. I think this is the last pass. Right, so you can just about see there is a mark there. So I'm going to try the other side, the blue laser. Yep, that'll do. So, green, blue light. I'm going to go to saturation 540. I'm going to set the power down to 30. Okay, so we're going to do two passes. I'll process it at that. Wait for those fumes to dissipate. Right. So we've got burn marks where the black is. We've got a pretty an alright marking of the actual material itself. Yeah, it's gonna. The infrared one you can barely see on the other side. I could probably see it better than you. So that's that one. So this is polyurethane. So we'll start with the same settings on the blue laser. There was an instant wisp of smoke that came up when that started. So that's two passes. There's no discernible mark. So I switch over to infrared. Make sure that the frame is okay. Yeah, that'll be. Two passes, we'll do that. the target. No real discernible, so I'm going to up the power. Yeah, 87%. Start straight away, same place, go. I can see some sort of mark. There is a slight mark in there. And just about see it. So I reckon we take the other side. And frame it so that we can't reduce it one there. And we go to that. What the that five set the duration to 2000. We'll do four passes. So I reckon we might be able to get the mark on this. It's going to take a little while, but... Thank you.
can't even see whether that's making it. I'm making a slight mark.
No, it's not gonna not doing very well. Barely got mark. So I'll try with the blue laser. Okay, 20% blue laser, same dot duration. We'll do two passes rather than four, because I think if we did four, we'd just eat through the material. Cancel that. Okay, so I'm gonna up the power a little bit. You can see the marks the other one's made and the light shining on it, so it has actually done something. I think I'm going to leave playing with the rotary tool for a little for another day. Last thing I'm going to do is I've got a different image that I'm going to put on the back of this brush. Okay, so it's actually burning it now. This should be the last pass. If it's not, I'm going to stop it. I'm a little bit ropey towards the end. Yeah, you can see it started to melt and scorch. That's what I was expecting to happen, to be fair. Right. So we're going to try and use a different image on this one. So delete that. Okay, so to resize it. Right, so this is... You want
you can actually see the laser on this one. That's kind of cool. I looked kind of cool on the screen, let's see. The lovely smell of burnt wood. Right, it's getting too cold now, you can see my breath. Going indoors after this one. Oh, and you can guarantee that I'm going to be marking all of my tools. So we know when it gets to points, that's when the heat is going to be concentrated, and there's a couple of points along this line. Okay, now that's very cool. Okay, that went deeper than I thought it did. That's done proper. That's really cool. Right, and on that note, I'm going to leave it there. Thanks for watching. Have a good weekend.